María Félix.
María de Los Ángeles Félix Guareña was born in Alamo, Sonora on April 8, 1914. Her parents were Bernardo Félix Flores, a Mexican military and politician, and Josefina Guareña Rosas. María grew up in Alamo with her parents and 11 siblings, with whom she shares an ancestry of Yaqui Indians on her father's side, and Basque Spanish on her mother's side. Her family later moved to Guadalajara, where she went to the University of Guadalajara and married in 1931 with Enrique Álvarez Alatorre, with whom in 1934 she had her first son, also an actor, Enrique Álvarez Félix. María Félix was an actress as great as her personality, a muse for writers, designers, and singers who brought the name of Mexico to the most important screens and film festivals in the world. María Bonita, or María de los Ángeles Félix Guareña, the Sonoran woman who, with the mystery that surrounded her, built the most important character of her career, that of herself. The arrival of María Félix to the cinema is due to a pure act of change. A meeting in the center of Mexico City would later make her the biggest star in her country. She was destined for a career in Hollywood, but her great character made her decide to star in Mexican cinema. María Félix was soon referred to as La Doña, a woman full of fantastic stories who conquered places with her career that seemed impossible for the woman of her time. With her career, she changed paradigms in the world of cinema. The role of women in films went from being that of a damsel to that of a lone donor. María Félix became the woman who chose her own roles. She was on one of the best paid of all in the middle, beyond a successful career with 47 films. La Doña's legacy extends outside of cinema. Her image was a symbol of luxury, style, and eccentricity. María was the main character not only of her films, but of an entire aesthetic explained only by her name. María Félix was the inspiration for fashion greats such as Balenciaga, Vivier, and Saint Laurent. Cartier's star claimed for her eccentric jewelry commissions, and the woman who is today an icon of contemporary style for the entire world. María Bonita, more than an actress, is a cultural symbol who left Mexico to become the world, an exotic and different character who will always be remembered. Now, as the diva of Mexico's golden age of cinema, she was the largest representative of the big screen in Mexico at an international level, also participating in recognized films in different European countries. Now, as María Bonita, or La Doña, for her role in the film Doña Bárbara in 1943, she also became a style icon of the time for her extravagant taste and ironic personality. She died on April 8, 2002 in Mexico City at the age of 88. The life of the actress was celebrated with a parade from the residence in Polanco to the streets of the historic center of the city, arriving at the Palacio de Bellas Artes, where a crowd of people paid tribute to La Doña in the lobby of the building. María Félix's coffin was also transported to the Jorge Negrete Theater to pay tribute to her. Finally, her remains were buried in the French Pantheon with her parents and her son. When she passed away, she left his entire fortune to his personal assistant for more than 28 years. Luis Martínez de Anda, the actress's inheritance included all her properties and her collection of works of art.